Morning, children. Hope you are safe by the grace of God. Last class we started with Unit 3, Service Business 1. We saw Chapter 10, Reserve Bank of India. In Reserve Bank of India, we saw like what is the meaning for bank. We saw the banking services. We saw the historical background of banks in India. We saw the origin of RBI and the organizational structure of RBI. This is a short recap of what we have learned last class. Before we go into today's topic, we should know what is a bank. A bank is a financial institution to license to receive deposits and make loans. Banks may also provide financial services such as wealth management, currency exchange and safe deposit boxes. Now we will see what are the functions of banks. The functions of banks are grouped under three heads. One is the leadership and supervisory function, the traditional function and the promotional function. First, we will see the leadership and supervisory function. India being the fastest growing economy in the world, India is expected to play a major role in the world affairs by many countries. RBI being the banking institutional head of the India as a part of global institution. It has to transform the quality and size of the banks in India to the level of other banks according to the world sector, to the world economy. Now we can see, under that we are going to see what is India going to do. What is the first function that Indian RBI is going to do? The first one is India is going to be a representative in the world financial institution. First one, to ensure, or we can say in order to maintain consistency and harmony with international banking standards, the RBI associated with the Basel Committee. What is Basel Committee? This committee was started in the year 1997. Okay. The main objective of this bank is to enhance the quality of banking supervision worldwide. We will see the first point states that RBI represents Government of India in International Bank of Reconstruction and Development, that is IBRD, that is World Bank, and International Monetary Fund IMF, in which India is a member since December 27, 1945. Next function is regulator and supervisor of Indian financial banking system. The broad guidelines for all banking operation in the country are formulated by the RBI. Okay, now the RBI has the power to issue currencies or to control and supervise the commercial banks. RBI is the apex bank. Okay, being the apex bank, it has got all the commercial banks under its control and it formulates the rules and regulations that has to be done. It supervises all the commercial banks according to the RBI Act of 1934 and the Regulation Act of 1945. It conducts inspection of the commercial banks and calls for returns and other necessary information from then onwards. Okay. And whatever that is from 1934, that according to the Act of 1934, since it was established, it collects all the information, it frames the rules and guidelines, everything for the commercial banks in India. Monetary Authority. RBI provides services. It provides advisors to the government concerning agricultural finance. Moreover, RBI formulates, implements and monitors the monetary policy of the country in order to maintain price stability, controlling inflationary needs, trends and the economic growth. Closely monitoring economic parameters. Okay, so broad economic parameters such as employment level, price levels and production levels, or trade cycles, foreign investment flows, balance of payments, financial markets are being closely monitored by RBI. Moreover, it also monitors all the achievements in the commercial banks. What all the commercial bank is doing, okay, it is closely monitoring it. The Board of Financial Supervision of the RBI meets at least once in every month, at times you can say, and they're closely monitoring all the current development that the country is doing. Okay, so commercial banks, what all the commercial bank is doing, they're closely monitoring and sees to that. That helps in the country's development. Promptly responding to challenges. Whenever challenges arise, okay, before the banking systems, like banking systems are huge. Okay, we have different kinds of banks. We saw development banks, scheduled banks, non-scheduled banks, cooperative banks, etc. Okay, so what they do is they issue, start issuing circulars. Okay, and they organize meetings. Once in a month, they organize meeting. Why are they doing this? They want to strengthen the Indian banking. A wealth of information can be found in every master circular or committee report. We can see here Gopalakrishnan Committee on Information Security Electronic Bank, April 2010. Okay, what does it say is according to this committee, the circular says that this committee was started to monitor the mitigating cyber threats that was emerging from the increase in the adoption of IT in the commercial banks in India. So what are the threats that happened in the IT sector, okay, due to the cyber threats, okay? All these were informed in the magazines, or we can say in the report of the Gopalakrishnan committee. Children, here are a few questions for you to answer, okay? Like as you know that the Central Bank of India is the RBI, okay? So mention the names of central banks in any other three countries, okay? Mention the name of central banks in any other three countries. You just write three countries and write how those country call their central bank as, okay? The name of that central bank as. The next question is, what is a white label ATM? What is a white label ATM? Write down the answer for this. Then one more question for you. Who was the first governor of RBI of India? Okay, who was the first governor of the Indian RBI? And who is the present governor of RBI India? Okay, Reserve Bank of India. Answer these questions and then you can continue watching the video. We will see the traditional functions of RBI. First traditional function is bank and the financial advisor to the government. So what is RBI doing? RBI is a financial advisor to the government. It does the work of giving advices. It says that how much of funds are necessary, how much of funds are there for, how much of funds are available in the bank. It accepts money in the central and the state government's accounts and makes payment on their behalf. It takes up the responsibility of investment of the surplus government funds. Monopoly of note issue. The RBI is the sole authority for printing and issuing of all currency notes in India. It is the duty of the RBI to ensure there is sufficient number of good quality currency notes that is available to the public. It exchanges currency and coins that is not fit for circulation. Moreover, we can see currency notes are printed at places like Nasik, Devas, Salboni, Mysore, etc. To be remembered that currency notes are not printed outside India. Next, Bankers Bank. Okay, the next function is the RBI's relationship between RBI and the other banks in the country is like a relationship between a customer with the commercial banks. When we go to commercial banks, if at all they know us, if we're going very frequently to the bank, they know us, they say, come sir, welcome sir, what may I help you, all those things. In such way, the such close relationship the RBI has with the commercial banks. It maintains the current accounts of all commercial banks in the country. Next function is controller of credit and liquidity. Controlling the credit money in circulation above the interest rates. Okay, what is the interest rate that is to be specified, that is there, is mentioned by the RBI. RBI fixes the interest rates for the commercial banks. According to those rates only, the commercial banks have to accept and give the interest rates to the customers. For this purpose, it is using a quantitative and qualitative methods of credit control. The next traditional function is lender of last resort. We can see like in times of emergency, we can say commercial banks, if at all they go for a losses, RBI helps them by providing them financial assistance. Okay, we can say RBI provides credit for the commercial bank. When sources of getting credit are exhausted, all banks obtain money or finance from the RBI, and hence it is called as the lender of last resort. Next, we can see clearing house services. The aggregate amount of checks whichever has been collected by the commercial banks are represented, and you can see all these claims have been presented in front of the RBI, and net settlement is done by the RBI. So RBI acts as a clearing house and maintains a clearing system for all the commercial banks in India. The next traditional function is custodian of foreign exchange reserves. The RBI maintains a reserve of gold and foreign currencies. When foreign exchange reserves are inadequate, we can say for meeting the balance of payments problems, it borrows from the IMF. What is IMF? You can say International Monetary Fund. So it, whenever there is less of finance or finance is not sufficient, RBI borrows from the IMF. It also administers exchange controls of the country and enforces the provisions of the foreign exchange management according to the Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999. Development and maintenance of foreign exchange management in India is also the main function of RBI. The next function is maintenance of foreign exchange rates. We can see like RBI manages the exchange value of the rupee in order to facilitate India's trade and payments. Collection or publication of authentic data. We can see it has also been entrusted with the task of collection and compilation of statistical information relating to banking and other financial sectors of the economy. So all the data that have been collected by the RBI must be correct, okay, it must be accurate. RBI monthly bulletin, annual report and various committee reports contain treasures of authentic data. Okay, so these are the traditional functions of RBI. Next we will see the promotional functions. First promotional function is nurturing banking habits among the public. Usually people, there's a public, okay, they deposit the money in the bank. The belief that their money is safe. All the informations that are given by the public to the bank must be confidential. So it is the responsibility of the RBI to maintain the public confidence in the banking system. It protects the depositors' interest and aims at providing cost-effective banking services. We can see it helps in order to include more people to avail banking services. It has taken up the task of extending the banking system in the areas where there are no banks. Okay, so banks are increasing more and more. We can find there are no banks, or we can see now, you can see there are no banks in certain places. So RBI is taking the initiative to set up banks in places where there are no banks. Okay, unbanked areas, we call them as unbanked areas. The next one is grievance settlements measures. Our grievance means, we can say, problems. Okay, so whatever problems are raised against a company or an organization, we can say RBI is appointed 20 up to 2017, according to 2017, they have appointed 20 ombudsmen. Okay, so what are these people doing? They are appointed to investigate, the complaints against the company or the organization. Okay, so Banking Ombudsman Scheme is a speedy and inexpensive forum for resolution of customer complaints relating to certain services that is rendered in the Reserve Bank of India. So whenever we have some problems regarding our banking accounts or our finance problems, okay, if at all we have some amount debited or credited in our accounts, okay, if at all we have some grievances, immediately we call for the customer case. Okay, so all these helps are done by the RBI. Agricultural development. RBI helps agricultural industry. So, okay, they give more preferences for agricultural department. So agricultural industry is specified as priority sector by the RBI. The loans of all scheduled banks should contain a percentage of loans to priority sector. So they're saying like if at all they have nominated or they have started up NABARD. Okay, what is NABARD? National Bank for Agricultural and Rural Development. So this has been started so that they can give a percentage of interest to the farmers. Okay, so it works in close association with NABARD to help agriculture in India, especially the farmers in India. Promotion of small scale industries. Same way, micro, small and medium enterprises are included in the priority sector. As we saw, agriculture is included, even MSME, okay, micro, small and medium enterprises are also included in the priority sector. All banks are required to open separate branches to specialize the financing of these industries. The next one is facilitating foreign trade. The RBI has simplified the rules for credit to exporters through which they can now get long-term advances for bank loans. The next topic is it is supporting the cooperative sector. As we can see, the cooperative sectors are started mainly for the service motive. Okay, so government exempts some taxes for them. So RBI also helps them in relaxing rules, okay, and providing indirect financing. Okay, we can see like being a service sector, corporate sector is being a service sector. So government is exempting some taxation for them. RBI is exempting certain or relaxing certain rules and regulations for the cooperative sector. Okay. Some information that you have to know is the rupee symbol was changed from rupees, that is RS, you know. Okay, that was changed from RS to the symbol that we are using now by the government of India on July 15, 2010. Okay, children, we will do a small recap of what we have learnt today's topic. In today's topic, we saw the functions of RBI. We saw the leadership and supervisory functions, the traditional functions, and the promotional functions. Now it is like your full attention or full enjoyment or full learning should be from your side. Okay, so you have to take up your test, children. Play your Kahoots, enjoy learning, watch the video once or twice to understand more. Come to the Zoom sessions because it is so interesting that you see your friends, okay, lively, you see your teacher. Okay, come join with us, learn more, be happy, be safe. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.